Hey, you've reached Alex, and tonight on my vlog, we're gonna talk about my favorite band, Red Hot Chili Peppers, you know. And it's my favorite band because they really did a lot for music, and they really influenced a lot of the music scene in the 80s and 90s. And no one had really seen anything like them before because there were some crazy white guys who really went into like using stuff like, rap and reggae and funk. A lot no one had ever really seen before, and they really innovated music forever. And now I think, the way they look about influential artists, and I'd say definitely of, the past 2 decades, I'd definitely say Red Hot Chili Peppers are the most influential of all of the artists, that are out and available. Of course, it started back like in 1985, when Anthony Kiedis and the bassist Flea met Hillel Slovak and Jack Irons. They started the first band, got together, did some early recordings, then eventually they stepped it up a notch. They became locally famous, and over the whole LA scene, it became a pretty big deal, and eventually they hit it off with John Frusciante, who, of course, is pretty much the backbone of their band now. I mean, it's like, you look at what he did for that band, and you look at what he did without them, and it doesn't even compare, that John Frusciante is definitely, of course, you look on Rolling Stone's top 100 greatest guitarist, and John Frusciante is like, what, he's like 17 or 18? Jack White's in front of him, which kind of surprised me. And I know Jack White's really innovative, and he's really, really original. And like, a lot of his rhythms and melodies are really something that you probably remember for a long time. But I guess in different ways, he doesn't compare to John. And I guess, in 1991, they had their big album, Blood Sugar Sex Magik, which is probably my second favorite. I like it a lot. And it's really their last one that had like the signature kind of like funk style. Have a lot of rapping on there too, and just really sick. Deals a lot with the biggest themes that's there, probably, illustrated in the title. Like, there's a lot of violence, gore, sexual themes, sensuality, everything that teenagers is into these days, and just really took it above and beyond. And it's probably one of the greatest albums of all time. You go on like anything about 90s or any kind of significant albums, you'll find Blood Sugar Sex Magik on there, And of course, after that, things have kind of changed with Chili Peppers. John Frusciante left because of, just, I guess it was creative differences, and also because of all the stress of touring, and what he wanted wasn't really what they're aiming for. He was kind of the guy that wanted to chill out and hang out, like in clubs, and perform for really small audiences. He couldn't handle touring on a large scale, playing to sold out stadiums. He didn't want it, so they left. And then they picked up Dave Navarro, who's really famous now for being on the whole rock star supernova scene and being the guy who was banging Carmen Electra for a while. Yeah, and just, yeah, things, their style definitely changed because Navarro kind of brought that really poppy sound to it, And with their, what was it, One Hot Minute, came out with them. And things were definitely different for a while, but really brought them back into our day and age was with 1999's album Californication, which brought things like, Scar Tissue and Around the World, a bunch of really good songs that, got won a lot of awards. Probably the best song on there was Scar Tissue because the rhythm and melody was so like unique. You never heard anything like it before, and just people like will hear the melody from that song or just the first opening notes, and you'll know that song, and it's just that's what it means, because you don't even have to know who wrote it or when it was made or how it was made, but just those song really just gives it away that, it was definitely talk of the time and just things went on. And my favorite album personally was the 2002 album, which was By the Way, which things have definitely taken to decline, from the past of Californication, Bloodshed. They got a lot of that really, you can still hear some of the, kind of like crazy funk themes that they had like in the 80s and 90s. But with this album, they really went new directions and stuff. They started letting John Frusciante compose all the guitar and bass lines, They're starting to write songs more around the instrumentals than writing the instrumentals about the songs. And I really kind of like the new direction they took, Some people don't, And I love all those songs. Like, that's the only album like I can listen to, like, every single song and, like, love it. Other songs on other albums I can't listen to because I just don't like them or just they bother me in one way or another. I don't know why, but they just do. And of course, the biggest thing was in 2006 they came out with Stadium Arcadium, and they it's what my generation, the whole like class of 2010 people, 09, 11 people graduating high school in that year, Because the biggest songs were probably Danny California, which was a big hit because, also kind of like Scar Tissue, no one really heard anything like it before, and just the chords progression, the solo, everything about that song was just number one. It's badass, and just what else? That Snow, which won an award for like best acoustic composition or something like that, and it's also an amazing song. I think you will never hear an artist that sounds anything like Red Hot Chili Peppers in your life at all, because that's just how unique they are, and they've really developed their own style, and I appreciate it a lot. And just, I guess they're on hiatus right now. It's 2008, and if they start touring again, I hope they come to Vegas, because I'm gonna be there, and I'm gonna watch them. Peace.